స్వానుభవం సనాతన సునవి కంపి సనత్ కుమార సనాతనభం సనగా సో సనత సనంతన అండ్ సనాతన సనత్ సనత్ కుమార సనాగ ఫ్రమ్ సో సనగ సనగ ఫ్రమ్ పరమేష్ఠి అండ్ పరమేష్ఠి ఫ్రమ్ బ్రహ్మ బ్రహ్మ ఫ్రమ్ నోబడీ బ్రహ్మ ఇస్ ద బిగినింగ్ అండ్ బ్రహ్మ స్వయంభూ బ్రహ్మై నమః బ్రహ్మై స్వయంభూ అండ్ టు దట్ బ్రహ్మ నమస్కార మహాశంకర్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ దట్ ప్రీవియస్ పేజ్ పరమేష్ఠి విరాట్ బ్రహ్మణ హిరణ్య గర్భాత్ సో సనాతన రిసీవ్డ్ ఇట్ ఫ్రమ్ సనగ అండ్ సనగ రిసీవ్డ్ ఇట్ ఫ్రమ్ పరమేష్ఠి పరమేష్ఠి ఇన్ ఫ్రమ్ విరాట్ అండ్ పరమేష్ఠి ఫ్రమ్ బ్రహ్మణ బ్రహ్మ హిరణ్య గర్భ మీన్ బ్రహ్మాజీ సో విరాట్ రిసీవ్డ్ ఇట్ ఫ్రమ్ హిరణ్య గర్భ ఆర్ బ్రహ్మాజీ దెన్ సే ఆనందగిరి కుతత్తరి బ్రహ్మణ విద్యా ప్రాప్తి వెర్ ఇస్ హిరణ్య గర్భ బ్రహ్మాజీ రిసీవ్డ్ ద నాలెడ్జ్ భాష్యకర సేస్ తత పరం ఆచార్య పరంపరా నాస్తి ఆచార్య పరంపరా బియాండ్ బ్రహ్మాయ బ్రహ్మా దేవానాం ప్రథమ సంభూవ విశ్వస్య కర్త భువనస్య గోప్త అండ్ బియాండ్ దాట్ దిస్ నో ఆచార్య పరంపర సో ఆనందగిరి ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ దాట్ స్వయం ప్రతిభాదవేద హిరణ్య గర్భ ఆచార్యాంతరం అపేక్షతే స్వయం ప్రతిభాద వేద హిరణ్య గర్భ ఇస్ ద వన్ హూ హ్యాస్ ది నాలెడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ వేదాస్ బై హిమ్సెల్ఫ్ సో నాలెడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ వేదా అకర్స్ యో బ్రహ్మాణం విదధాది పూర్వం యో వై వేదాంశ ప్రహిణోది తస్మై సో ను బ్రింగ్ బ్రహ్మాజీ టు మేనిఫెస్టేషన్ యునో ను బ్రహ్మా ఇంపార్ట్ ది నాలెడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ వేదాస్ టు బ్రహ్మాజీ ఇన్ దాట్ సెన్స్ ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ యూ కెన్ ట్రేస్ ఇట్ టు నారాయణ బట్ హియర్ హిరణ్య గర్భ బ్రహ్మ ఇస్ వన్ ఇన్ హోమ్ ద నాలెడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ వేదాస్ అకర్స్ బై హిమ్సెల్ఫ్ Therefore, there is no need for him that we have expectation of another teacher. Ishvara anugrahitasya tasya buddhau avirbhutat vedadeva vidyalabha samvadityartha Ishvara anugrahitasya Ishvara is Paramatma. So Hiranyagarbha, because of the grace of the Paramatma, tasya buddhau avirbhutat vedat. So the Veda just manifests itself in the buddhi. That's how we read the stories. So how Brahmaji appears in a lotus which arises from the navel of Lord Narayana, then Brahmaji performs the tapasya, then Lord Narayana appears to him, and then gives him the knowledge of the Vedas, and that's how Brahmaji actually creates this universe. So, Ishvarana Grahitasya, Tasya Buddhau, Ishvara means Param Brahma. By the anugraha of that, the Vedas appear in the buddhi of Hiranyagarbha, Tasmadeva, Vidyalava, Sambhavat, and then, that is how the Sambhava, Vidyalabha Sambhava. So that's how the Vidyalabha is there for Hiranyagarbha. And therefore, Atasparam, Acharya Parampara Nasti. There is no Acharya Parampara beyond that. Kutastarhi Vedo Jayate. Where does the Veda then arise from? Yat Punahaiti. So Vashyakara says, Yat Punaha Brahma Tannityam Swayambhu. Yat punha brahma. Then brahma is nityam. It is eternal. Brahma can also be said to Veda actually. But brahma here means param brahma, which is nityam, swayambhu, self-existing. Everything exists after him, but he is self-existing. Everything shines after him, he is self-shining. So says Anandagiri, parasyeva brahmanaha veda rupena avasthanat tasya nityatvat న హేతు అపేక్షా ఇత్యర్థ పరస్యేవ బ్రహ్మణ వేద రూపేణ స్థానాత్ ఇట్ ఇస్ పరం బ్రహ్మ పరం బ్రహ్మ అలోన్ దట్ మేనిఫెస్టెస్ వేద దేర్ఫర్ ద వేద ఆల్సో ఇస్ కాల్డ్ బ్రహ్మ అండ్ సో పరస్యేవ బ్రహ్మణ పరం బ్రహ్మ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ వేద రూపేణ స్థానాత్ దట్ అలోన్ ఒబ్టైన్స్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ వేదాస్ తస్య నిత్యత్వాత్ పరం బ్రహ్మ ఇస్ నిత్య వేద ఆల్సో ఇస్ నిత్య న హేతు అపేక్షా దేర్ఫర్ దిస్ నో రీజన్ ఇస్ టు హౌ వేదాస్ కేమ్ అబౌట్ బికాస్ Param Brahma alone is Veda knowledge. Param Brahma means Satyam Jnanam. That Jnanam alone so manifests itself in the form of Vedas. So Veda is always Nitya. Therefore there is no question of where Vedas came from because they are eternally there. And they just manifest themselves by the grace of the Lord in the buddhi of Hiranyagarbha. That's how Hiranyagarbha also gains the knowledge. And now Hiranyagarbha doesn't have the need to learn it from anybody, but by the grace of the Lord, these Vedas actually reveal themselves in the mind of Hiranyagarbha. That's how he becomes the first teacher, then Parameshthi, then Sanaga, then Sanatana. And that's how the Parampara. So Sanat Kumaras are the Manasaputra of Brahmaji, of Hiranyagarbha. So they are the first recipients of the knowledge. Adavante Chakrata Mangalaha Granthaha Prachayana Bhavanti. When there is a Mangalam, Adavante Cha, the beginning as well as the conclusion, when there is Mangalam, then Granthaha Prachayana Bhavanti. Then this Grantha, Prachayana Bhavanti. Then the Granthas actually spread. Then they actually find, they spread among the adhikaris. Iti devadaitam ante brahmane namaha iti uktam. This is, the Shruti herself says, brahmane namaha. Shruti says, Veda says, brahmane namaha. Salutation to Brahma, param Brahma. And actually Shruti need not do that, because it is Brahma. Actually it says, brahmane namaha. So because this is the mantra, will be repeated by others. So they should repeat brahmane namaha. That's how even the whole Upanishad also is repeated by people. So repeat the whole text. We have, by the way, the cassette also. This Brihadaranyaka Upanishad of the Kanva Shaka has been recited by the Panditas, and of course the whole Veda is recited, of which Brihadaranyaka is a part. This is the Shukla Yajurveda style, of course, and that too Kanva style. There is a Madhyandari style also. So this Shukla Yajurveda is primarily in North India, but it is in South India also. But again, Shukla Yajurveda has these two recensions, Madhyandari and Kanva. Although the Kanva recension is generally in South India, Madhyandari recension is in North India. Therefore, the Shukla Yajurvedis of North and South also will pronounce differently. First of all, Krishna Yajurveda is a style that in which we pronounce the mantras, which are different from the way Shukla Yajurveda is pronounced, like Rudram and everything. Of them also, the way the South Indian Shukla Yajurveda is pronounced will be different from the North Indian Shukla Yajurveda, because Kanva and Madhyandini. Of that, this is the Kanva Shaka Upanishad, because Shankaracharya must have South India, and therefore he has adopted this Kanva recension of also Ishavasya Upanishad, both. So, Upanishads are, there are Swaras here, and Swaras are available. Mantra Pushpam, this whole Upanishad is there with Swara. And one peculiarity of the Shukla Yajurveda you will find is all anudatta, there is no udatta Swara. Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat. There is no Purnam Uchyate, there is no such thing. Uchyate, So, Shanti, Shanti or something. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Purnat, Purnam Udachyate, no. Purna Mudachyate, Either it is anudatta or it is just Swaripa is elongation, or it is Madhyama. And so either Madhyama without any enunciation or anudatta. That's how it is. Anyway, so Brahmani Namah iti uktam. So Bhashyakara says here, last sentence, Tasmai Brahmane Swayam Bhuve Namah. Rashikara explains, Tasmai Brahmane Swayambhuve Namaha. To the Swayambhu, self-existing Lord, our salutation. Foot number one says, Swayambhuve Namaha iti. Veda rupena avasthiraya Brahmane vang manah kaya kratah prasvi bhavahastu ityartha. What is namaskara? The threefold salutation. Vang manah kaya. The salutation in speech. But salutation in speech is followed by the salutation in the mind, and also is expressed as salutation at the level of body. Veda rupena avasthitaya brahmane, so Brahman, Paramatma, who obtains the form of the Vedas, to that Vedas, that is Paramatma in the form of the Vedas, our salutation through words, through speech, through the body, through the speech and through the mind. Therefore in the Ashtanga, Sashtanga Namaskara, the speech and mind are also included, and the six limbs of the body. Vang manah kaya kratah prahvi bhavastu ityartha. Prahvi bhavah means this bending down. Vedatmane shreyortibhi त्रिधाभिनव भक्ति श्रद्धाभ्याम सदा कार्यम इति सूचते. Thereby, what is indicated here? What is suggested is Shreyorthi Bhi, those are desire of Shreya, meaning the moksha. Vedatmane, to Vedatma, there is Brahma, who is of. So Vedatma, Veda is Atma, or one is Atma of the Veda. To that Brahman, Tridhavi Namaha Karyam. So the Shreyorthi meaning that those mumukshus must actually salute the Vedas and salute the Lord and the Father of the Veda in a threefold way. How bhakti shraddha abhyam karyam, with bhakti devotion and the shraddha, this namaskara, this salutation must be done to the Lord in the form of the Vedas. This is the explanation of that. So the tippanikara gives his own conclusion. Tat anena dhyayena brahma vidya sutram brahmana panchakena prapanchitam. I don't remember if this was done in the end of the first chapter, it wasn't, but here, anena dhyayana, by the second chapter, brahma vidya sutram brahmana panchakena prapanchitam brahma vidya sutram atmetya opasita aham brahmasmi. That brahma vidya expressed in the aphoristic form has been expounded in the first five brahmanas of this beginning ajavashatru, then shishu brahmana, murtamurta brahmana, maitreyi brahmana, madhu brahmana. By these five brahmanas, that sutra has been expounded in great detail. Vidya-vishasya, madhukandasya, pumbundhyut-prekshita-tva-shankabhi-nirākrata-bhavati. Another important reason why this vamsha, the lineage, is given is that vidya-vishasya, madhukandasya, this madhukanda. So, this madhukanda of which the subject matter is Brahma Vidya, somewhere I read it. On the page 666, the first footnote, which we did not read, you know. So something was missing somewhere. Japas is saving. Japastu Brahma Vidya Utpatte. This japa is for Utpatti of Brahma Vidya, for arising of Brahma Vidya. Tathasha Vartike, Vartikara says, Japoyam namba vijnana janmani chodyate shruta viti. Japoyam brahma vijnana janmani chodyate shruta. Shruti is enjoining this japa of this vamsha brahmana for the utpatti of brahma vidya. Japarthascheri cha shabdartha avartike mahasaka japarthascha. So this vamsha brahmana is meant for japa also. What is also? Vartikara explains the chakara. Pumatyuhochidashanka nivrityartham yathoditam brahmajnana sivavamsha yatna chutya yamuchade. Pumati uha uchita ashanka nivrityartham. This brahmajnana actually uchitam has arisen from pumati. Uha means the reasoning. So uha poha. That this is a product of the reasoning or the intellect of the individual, human being. That Brahma Vidya is a product of the human mind. This kind of a shanka may arise. That shanka nivrtyartham, in order to eliminate the doubt that this Brahma Vidya or this Madhukanda may be a product of the figment of the imagination or figment of the human mind. So that is why this whole Vamsha Brahmana is said. It comes all the way from Brahma and from Param Brahma. Brahma Jnana Siva Vamsha Yatna Shrityaya Muchade. Or you can say that Vamsha, the whole lineage of Brahma Jnanam, has been said by Shruti in so many words, Yatna Duchale. So say the Tika, Prakrita Brahma Jnanasya Purusha Buddhi Utprekshita Tvashankana Vrtyatyam Brahmanam. That this Brahma Jnanam is not a product of the human imagination. Kummateti Vamsha Upanya Nyasasya Yatnaha Bahushaha Vachanam. That this Vamsha has been described in such great detail. Just to say that, Shruti goes to the great length to make sure that this shanka does not remain, that this is a product of somebody's mind. Atra yathoditam iti brahma jnanasya visheshanam yathoditam brahma jnanam avyai bhavatvad avyayam. Yatha is avyaya, it's avyai bhava samasa. Yathoditam Avyayavaha samasa always is without any declension. Or certain samasas are declined with makara, say asoditam, or yathamati, no declension. Or declined in the accusative singular, yathoditam, neuter, accusative singular, yathoditam. So this is avyayavaha samasa. So therefore the brahmajnana is avyayam. Avyayavaha samasa yathoditam, Vardhikara writes to say that brahmajnana is avyayam. Avyayam means it is uncreated also, it is undying and uncreated. Not a product or not actually created by somebody. So going back to our page 669 at the bottom, Padayana Dhyayana Vishayana Brahma Vidya Sutram Brahmana Panchakena Papanchitam Vidya Vishayasya Madhukandasya Pumbuddhi Uprekshita Prashankara Nirakrata Bhavati. That is Brahma Vidya, which subject matter Madhukanda is not a product of the human intellect, so that doubt also has been eliminated. Brahma Mula Vamsa Brahmana, that way the Vamsa Brahmana also serves the purpose, various purposes, among them being that this is a valid knowledge, authentic knowledge, and not coming down from an individual, it is Dhyayam. We pride in this. We pride in saying that the knowledge is not a product of human mind, where other people pride in saying that their scriptures come from a person. Your Vedas don't come from an individual. Our Quran comes from Muhammad. And Bible comes from Christ, you know, they pride themselves in that. That there is a dharma pravartaka. We pride in saying there is no pravartaka here, that it is coming down and there is no one individual to whose buddhi it is confined. So how different people take pride in different ways. But we take pride in saying that Vedas are not a product of an individual. So even if you say so many rishis are there, not just one. And therefore it does not suffer from the limitation of the perception of one person. It is Dhyayam. So that is the purpose that the Vamsa Brahmana also serves. Okay. So this is how the first text is concluded. Yeah. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Suprabhashyakrutau Vande Bhagavanta Punah Punah Ishvara Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri.